Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the shortsaleshow.com. My name is Jamie Cox. Today is Monday, June 25th. It's actually really early in the morning on Monday, and you can probably tell that by my eyes. I do have my liquid energy for the day. I did opt for the small can, though, because I'm trying not to drink as many of these things. One day they're going to be illegal. I guarantee you that. But that's not what I wanted to talk about today. Today I wanted to talk about FHA short sales. My team and I, we put a property on the market over the weekend that is serviced by Bank of America and backed by FHA. So I thought I'd take the opportunity to do a video on the differences between a traditional short sale and an FHA short sale. Now, it is a HUD program, or it is a government program. So of course there's going to be hoops to jump through. There's all sorts of guidelines and things that have to be met in order to qualify for it, but it's not so bad. And actually, they don't even use the term short sale. They call it their pre-foreclosure sale program or something. You know, they have to make things a little difficult. I joke around a little bit, but I actually like the program, believe it or not. One of the things that I like about it is all of the cards are on the table. And what I mean by that is, a lot of the banks, when you're doing a short sale with them, they try to withhold information to make the process a little more difficult. I don't know if they try to make the process a little more difficult, but they withhold information that makes the process a little more difficult. And I guess they believe it gives them the upper hand in the transaction for some reason. But with an FHA short sale, all the cards are on the table. So when they do an appraisal, the seller and the seller's agents actually get a copy of that appraisal. Once the appraisal comes back, you're given a letter called the approval to participate. And within that letter, it says the minimum net proceeds that they will accept in order to close on the short sale. So all that means for you is, once you get the approval to participate, we go out and find an offer that nets them more than their minimum proceeds, and we close. It's a pretty cool process. It's not quite that simple. If you are considering putting your home on the market, you really want to make sure you work with an agent that is familiar with the FHA short sale process. Another thing I like about the process itself is that they understand, they being HUD, they understand that once a listing's on the market, that after a certain amount of time it goes stale, or I guess that's the best way to describe it, a stale listing, where the longer it's on the market, the chances of getting offer on the property go down, or the less desirable it is. Maybe there's some problems with it or something. So the longer it's on the market, they have a tiered minimum net proceeds. So the longer it's on the market, the less they're willing to accept. And that's the kind of help avoid the problem of putting the home on the market and it sitting for a very long time. So long story short, it is a pretty cool process. Now the good thing for homeowners, there are incentives for homeowners to participate in the pre-foreclosure sale program, as they call it. So from the time that you apply for the pre-foreclosure sale program through HUD, they give you a certain amount of time to close. And if you close within this time frame, you get $1,000 at close of escrow. Now, if for some reason you go over this time frame, they'll reduce it down to $750, but nonetheless, you still get some sort of incentive that'll help you move and relocate whenever you close on your short sale transaction. Now, Nevada has actually taken it one step further. Nevada has a program called Nevada Hardest Hit Funds. And if you qualify for an FHA short sale, when you get your approval letter, you submit your application to the state, and you may qualify for up to $8,000 in relocation assistance from the state, in addition to the $1,000 from HUD. And the actual number, I think, is $8,025 or something strange, but we'll say $8,000 just to be safe. So with the HUD incentive of $1,000 and the additional money that you could possibly get from the state, putting your home on the market as an FHA short sale is starting to make a lot of sense. If you have questions on the FHA short sale process or any of the guidelines, the requirements that are needed on the listing agreement or within the offer, maybe some of the things that HUD will not pay for, because there's a lot of things that they won't pay for it. If a buyer asks for it or a seller asks for it, it doesn't fall within the guidelines. So they're not going to do it. So if you have questions on FHA short sale process, the guidelines, anything to do with HUD or FHA pre-foreclosure sale program, give me a call. My direct number is 702-487-0000. Again, 702-487-0000.